My name is Edward Waddell. We are at Drexel University. So I'm investigating the mechanisms behind the underlying function of a protein in a specific subtypes of neurons, specifically mature neurons. And the reason we're looking at this protein is because it's implicated in neurodevelopmental diseases, schizophrenia specifically, and Pitt-Hopkins syndrome. So I'm actually from South Jersey, not too far from here. I grew up on a farm in South Jersey. I'm a scientist because I want to help people. More so, I don't want to just help people in the medical sense, as in, you know, being a doctor, prescribing medications to them, or seeing sick people, you know, because what they're doing is they're treating people with what is already known. I want to be, you know, the person behind the scenes, able to come up with ways to treat them, come up with reasons why people suffer with certain diseases that they're suffering with that isn't known yet, to really just discover what's unknown and to use it to help people with certain diseases just have a better quality of life.
Let's do it. Yep.
The short-term outcome of my research is to definitely understand just the basic mechanisms behind what this protein is doing in mature neurons. The protein we're looking at, daughterless, it's known what it does during neurodevelopment, but not very much is known about what it does after development. So if I can just figure out what it can bind to and how it functions, that would be a giant step into understanding how it's actually accomplishing what it's doing in the mature neurons. Life in the lab's a lot more fun than just sitting behind a computer screen or being in a dark room, you know. Definitely, you know, interacting with people in the lab, interacting with people in other labs. The one thing I will say here at Drexel is we have a very, like, open culture for the labs. So labs aren't sequestered away and keep to themselves. Everyone's interacting, sharing ideas. That's really important to, you know, talk about your ideas and get new ideas and an outside perspective on what you're learning. You know, you have to work hard in the lab, but you also have to be able to go outside and have fun and build. You know, it's not just being in a lab with a bunch of people, it's being in a lab with your friends. My research turns out to be amazing. I guess, you know, definitely the next step in my career would be, you know, going for my postdoctoral studies. But ultimately, I would also like to teach, you know, within my career. I did my first 2 years of my college at a community college in New Jersey. So definitely, you know, going back and educating undergraduate and graduate students, you know, kind of paying it all forward. You'll never get tired of it. You know, you'll never get bored with what you're doing. There's room to take your career any which way you want. Spend a few years doing one thing, you can switch to another. You're not going to be just working the tedious 9-to-5 every day. It's a lot of fun, and not many people can say that they discover things that have never been found, and that's really exciting. That's what keeps you motivated and keeps you going.